I've lost my momentum. I need a bit of coaching and a kick up the backside to get back on track. And I thought you would be the perfect guy.
I'll just put my shoes on. Here we go.
So I got to like lesson four. What's it called? Not lesson.
Module four.
Module four, mm-hmm. as you know, and then I kind of had a change of heart during the experience, and went back to module one, and then just realized that was a mistake. So I'm back to module four again with my original, slightly improved positioning statement, yes. And that whole process has just made me lose my momentum, and now I just find myself watching TV at night, even though I berate myself and say you shouldn't do this. I need to get back onto this. I have like a list of things I need to do. I know what to do. Know how to get forward. And I think there is a fear there, and I don't know what it is. And if I was coaching myself, I would say, what's the fear? But it's in my blind spot and I can't see it. You know, I've had a look at the fear of being successful, a look at the fear of making too much money, the various fears that there's something going on that's just holding me back. And I thought you being a coach might be able to help me find it.
Wow. That is very vulnerable of you. Well done, guy. Very impressed, very self-aware, very impressive. So congratulations, well done. Let's see if I can help you out, all right? You want to do your webinar, but for some reason you've caught this disease called procrastination and it's stopping you, yes?
Yeah.
Good. And you want to create a webinar for what purpose?
Create the webinar so that I can attract people that I can help.
Good. And you really want to do that, yes, Guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. And if I had a client here for you right now, you'd take them on and you'd be able to help them?
Yeah.
So there's no issues there. You know you can deliver, yes?
Yeah, yeah.
So the delivery, that's not a problem. How much do you want to charge for this? Well, how much is it worth? How much do you want to charge?
I can't remember the figure I put, but it was somewhere around about $4,000 or $5,000.
All right, let's assume it's five.
Okay. Yeah.
Are you okay accepting $5,000 for your help?
Yeah, I don't have a problem with the amount of money.
All right, good. And if you had 10 clients give you $5,000, that's $50,000. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Good. Thank you. We got no problems there. Yes. How do you feel about selling?
I was a very successful salesperson in my 20s in the IT industry, and I haven't really done it since then. I've been more.
How do you feel about it? Thank you. How do you feel about it?
It's not something I enjoy, but I can do it.
All right, good. Thank you for your honesty. So, and then let's talk about the actual webinar presentation. How do you feel about doing that?
I don't know. I haven't really thought about it.
Let's have a think about it. How do you feel about creating a webinar presentation?
It's a little bit of an unknown. I mean, I've not done one before.
Do you feel about it?
So I feel a little bit apprehensive, I suppose.
Good. Thank you. Very good. Where are you at with your slides?
I think I mean, you've got all this text, and I've just sort of changed a few words on the text and started slotting things in.
Mm.
Not very far.
You haven't completed it yet, though, right?
No. Just started. Oh, and I haven't started it this time around. That was the last time around. That's when I stopped and went back.
Gotcha. So this webinar, we get to the webinar, and it becomes this, like, quicksand for you. It sucks you in. You go, oh, I can't move. Yes?
I guess so, yeah.
Well, it either is or it isn't. Which one is it? I mean, I've got to try and get to the truth here. It's the webinar that's the issue, is it?
I don't know if it's the webinar or the whole thing, the whole big thing of setting up a successful business, becoming financially independent, or whether it's just this step. I don't know.
Hold on a second. You have some fear attached to the success of this. Is that right?
Maybe, yes.
Well, it's
that's something that's something I'd looked at with Alyssa when I was chatting to her, yeah.
It's either a yes or a no. Which one do you think it is?
Yeah, I do think I have fear of success, yeah.
Good one. Thank you very much. Very, very honest of you. Well done. And so let's think about that because, if you don't – and other people watch this might feel the same, by the way. If you don't get over this fear of succeeding, what are we going to do every time?
Procrastinate.
And you're doing it, and you've been doing it, so it's obvious, right? There's no guesswork here. You're stopping this for a reason. You are afraid of something. You're afraid of something, right? Of what it means or how it's going to make you feel. You're afraid of something because we will do more to avoid pain than we will to gain pleasure. We will do more to avoid pain than we will to gain pleasure. You want the business. You want to help. You're happy to have clients. What you don't want, what you're afraid of, is what success either means or how it's going to feel. Yes?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Yeah.
Good. Thank you. All right. So all we have to do is change what it means and you'll be on your way.
Okay.
You get that, right?
Yeah.
Because we change the meaning, we change the emotion.
Yeah.
So what does it mean to you? If you were a success right now, what does it mean to you?
I think I was very successful in my 20s and I made a lot of money. And I kind of came to a realization that money doesn't actually change anything. I was still the same. I still had the same hang-ups and the same fears and the same having all those extra zeros on the end of my bank balance didn't really help me be able to do anything other than travel more. And I used to just get on planes and go to different countries and travel around the world.
And then was this sort of, are you saying there was some sort of emptiness that after that?
Very much an emptiness. I all that money made me very empty, yeah.
And then why would we go and try and be successful again if it's going to make us feel empty, yes?
Yeah. So I have this conflict of wanting to help other people, but if I look back in the last few years, I've helped a lot of people, but done it for free. Yeah. You know, I've been.
How'd that make you feel, by the way? How'd that make you feel?
It made me feel great that I was helping people, and it made me just feel a little bit like, well, I should be getting something for a little bit of resentment that I should be getting some money for doing all this work, uh-huh, putting in all this time and working on these courses. And
So it made you feel good to help others. So yes.
Yeah.
And when you earn money when you're younger, were you helping people or what were you selling?
Software, database software.
Eh, okay. Yeah. Whereas now you want to coach and actually truly make a difference. Yes.
Yeah.
So the longer you wait, the longer those people go without the help, you realize.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel? You said you care. So how does it make you feel?
It makes me sad, which kind of puts me back into the spiral. And then I go back to the procrastination. And what am I going to do about this? Oh, I'll just watch TV. And then that doesn't help.
No. So the actions you're taking aren't helping, but you obviously think they're helping. That's why you're doing them.
On some level, I must be thinking they're helping, yeah, but they're not.
And are they really helping? Is watching TV going to solve that tonight?
No.
No. And you're searching for purpose. You're searching for meaning.
Yes.
You hate the emptiness, and yet you're watching something which makes you feel
numb, I think. It just, TV just numbs me.
Yeah. Why would we choose that as an option then? When you know what you really want, you're choosing something else that makes you feel fairly average, if not numb.
Yeah.
So we've got to eliminate that as a solution. That's not making you feel any better, yes?
Correct.
What's the cost of keeping on watching TV at night rather than actually working on what's going to help people?
I'm running out of time. I mean, I'm in my 50s now. You know, I'm not in my 20s anymore.
You already knew that. That isn't a big surprise. What's the cost of that, though?
The cost is that, you know, I won't end up leaving a legacy. I won't end up leaving a mark on the planet, and having left this planet at the end of my life, having helped lots of people and changed. I want to make a difference to the world.
So you say. Well, meanwhile, turning on the TV.
Do you know, maybe there's a bit of a fear of the unknown in there as well? Just stepping into this whole setting up a venture.
Yeah, but you're assuming that the unknown is a negative. Instead of the unknown could be really exciting and wonderful. You're putting a negative slant on the unknown.
It must be, yeah.
You're choosing to do that, by the way, because you don't know what the unknown is. No one does. That's why it's unknown. But it could be awesome. What if it's awesome rather than bad? Why assume it's going to be negative?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of unlike me because like I just jump on planes and go to foreign countries and you know without any fear and without any money sometimes and just I can just make things happen and manifest things very quickly. So this kind of behavior that I'm doing is very unlike me. You know, I don't normally watch television. I'm not that kind of person, but I've just fallen into this hole and I just need to get out of it.
So what's it costing you to keep on taking the safe route?
It's probably going to make me ill eventually. It's probably just going to manifest in my body somehow, and I'll get tired, I'll get ill, because I'm not living up to my potential and not fulfilling my dreams and chasing what the things that I set out to do, which is would be a sad thing to end up doing that. I just have to hope this is a temporary blip and I can get out of it and get on with my life. God, I sound like I'm depressed. I'm not depressed, by the way.
Well, go back and watch TV then, if you're fine.
I mean, everything else in my life is going well. I mean, I'm recently
married. Yeah, great. Good for you. Great.
Yeah.
That's not what we're here to talk about. Go back and watch TV. If everything's so great, go back and watch TV.
And I'm not saying it's great. I'm just saying I don't think I'm clinically depressed and need medication or anything like that. You know,
again, you're avoiding the topic. Thank you. I know you're fine. You're all good. But if everything's fine in terms of helping people, then go back and watch TV. Or if you truly care, do something different.
Well, I need to do something different, that's for sure, because what I'm doing now is not working.
And how does that make you feel?
Like a failure, I suppose. I'm failing at the mission I set out to do when I signed up for your course. And I know that, you know, there is no such thing as failure, and every failure is a learning experience. So there has to be something here that I need to learn from this experience and use it to help me and help others.
It's going to produce a great story. It's going to produce a great story. You're going to be able to, you know, walk in their shoes because you've been there.
Yeah. And the irony is that by watching TV, I'm not even doing my own writing, let alone helping others with their writing. I'm just kind of doing nothing. So I'm kind of experiencing what I was thinking my clients would be experiencing and that what I'd be helping them with, I've actually fallen into it myself. Which, like you say, if I can, when I overcome this, it will make me a much better coach and help people with their writing. But at the same time, it makes me kind of sound a bit like a fraud because I'm claiming that I can help people do something that I'm stuck in myself.
Completely. If you go back to watching TV, you'll sound like a fraud.
Yeah. So that has to stop. The TV watching, I mean. And I just need to get back on the horse. And
because the cost of not getting back on the horse is,
well, initially sadness, eventually probably illness, and the loss to other people that I could have been helping. Cost that other people are not going to be fulfilling their dreams and writing their books and doing the things that they would have done if I had been coaching them. That last thing I said just impacted me, yeah. I can feel a lump in my throat.
And we can see it. You cared enough to come on the call and ask, and you cared enough to answer my questions. You're pretty serious.
Okay, so I need to get this webinar up and running.
Dude, it is your plane to an adventure. Remember how you used to feel getting on the plane there? The webinar's the plane. And I'm your ticket.
There we go. So change, you said change the meaning. So the meaning could be an adventure. It's an adventure. Because I like adventures.
Everyone does. Yeah. You saw it as a chore, and really it's an adventure. Who knows where it could lead?
Okay. Let's change the posture. And move forward with my adventure.
Yes.
All right. Thank you, Brett.
I'm very proud of you. To do what you just did there takes a lot of guts. Well done, man. Now, the problem with what you've just done, you've just done it publicly, released with amongst about 36 people. Now, we all know about it now. But you use that as motivation because now we all know that you have committed to this. If you don't do it, that's going to cause even more pain. Are you with me?
Yeah.
So when can we expect some version of your slides to be reviewed?
Is it doable within a week?
Absolutely. It's absolutely.
Well, I'll do it. I'll do it within a week then. I'll have a version up before the next seminar.
It's very important that you don't
next,
break
Q&A. Right?
Sure. A week from now. Very important you don't break that commitment because you just made it publicly and you made it personally. And if you're in inner integrity, you cannot break that now. You need to move heaven and earth to make that happen. And the slides won't be perfect.
Yeah, it'll be first draft. Version one.
I expect to see it, Guy, yes?
Okay.
Well done, man. Well done.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. I love your whole intention. I love it all, man. It's fantastic. And you're fighting for it. Well done. And I think you've just helped a whole bunch of people here as well. With that vulnerability, you've just helped a whole bunch of people here. You're already helping. And all you did was commit to maybe doing your slides today or in the next week. That's all you did. And you're already inspiring these folks. Feel good?
Thank you. You're inspiring me. That's great.
Well, that's an awesome transaction. Well done, man. Well done. Really well done.